Hi, this is Gary with MacMOST.com. Today let's take a look at different types of Mac USB and Thunderbolt ports. MacMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MacMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign. Join us and get exclusive content and course discounts. So I often get questions about the different types of ports that come on Macs. You've got USB ports, but there are different types of USB ports like USB-A or USB-C. You also have Thunderbolt ports, but Thunderbolt 1 and 2 ports look different than Thunderbolt 3 ports. And sometimes a port is called USB and sometimes it's called Thunderbolt. So which is it? So let's take a closer look at the different types of ports and try to unravel the mystery. So there are three main types of physical ports that we'll be talking about. Here's one, and it's usually just called a USB port. It has looked the same for more than two decades and you're probably familiar with it. It can do all sorts of things. You can use it to hook up a keyboard or mouse to your computer. You can also hook up various different types of drives, including the little flash drives. You can power devices, like for instance you can charge your iPhone from this port. You can even power little gadgets. Sometimes there's little LED flashlights or even fans and all sorts of things that can be powered with a USB port like this. And you can hook up tons of computer peripherals. Things like printers, scanners, webcams, all sorts of things use this. After all, the U in USB stands for universal, so it could be used for lots of different purposes. Now if you have an older Mac, even one that's just a few years old, you may have a port that looks like this. It's a Thunderbolt port, but technically it's Thunderbolt 1 or 2. But also, sometimes a port that looks exactly like this isn't a Thunderbolt port at all. Sometimes it's something called a mini display port. And we'll talk about that in a minute. Now a basic Thunderbolt port or mini display port can be used to connect an external screen to your Mac. You can even get an adapter for it that will go and allow you to hook up an HDMI television to your Mac. You can also use Thunderbolt to hook up external storage like external hard drives, although Thunderbolt drives are harder to find than USB drives. And you can do a variety of other things with it. For instance, you can get an external graphics processing unit to increase the graphics performance of your Mac. You can hook up video capture devices. You can even hook up an adapter to allow your Mac to connect over Ethernet to a network. And there are also docks that you can get for Thunderbolt ports that take the Thunderbolt port and then give you things like several USB ports, maybe HDMI, maybe an SD card reader, all sorts of things like that. Now if you have a newer Mac, you don't have either of these ports. You have a port that looks like this and takes cables that look like this. These are USB-C ports. So it gets confusing because this will be referred to as a USB port just like the USB-A port. But the shape is clearly different. Now to make it even more confusing, this is often referred to as a Thunderbolt 3 port. And we'll take a look at why both names are actually correct. Now in addition to doing all the other things that a Thunderbolt 1 or 2 port could do, you can also use this to power your Mac. So the power into your Mac can go through this USB-C port. But you can also use this to connect older USB devices, ones that require the USB-A port. You can just get a simple adapter for those. So the real reason for a lot of confusion about these ports is the fact that when you talk about something like USB or Thunderbolt, you're actually talking about two different things. You're talking first about the physical port itself, and second about the type of connection, the language that is being spoken between your computer and whatever is connected to it. So first looking at physical ports, we can see there's the USB-A port. There's also something called a USB-B port. You won't find that on any Mac. But usually you'll find it on peripherals like a printer or scanner. It'll have a port that looks like this. So you have a cable that on one end is USB-A and the other USB-B. Now the newer type of port is USB-C. It's a little smaller and most importantly it's bi-directional. In other words, you can plug it in either way. USB-A ports, you had to plug it in a certain way, and if you plugged it in the wrong way it wouldn't go in and you had to turn the cable around to make it fit in. With USB-C it doesn't matter. Now a fourth type of port is a Thunderbolt 1 or 2 port. And as I said before, this is also the same physical shape as a mini display port connector. So now let's look at connection types and you can see we're going to use the same names here, which is why it gets very confusing. So you have various types of USB connections. The original connection, just called USB or USB 1, was actually very slow and wasn't very good for data transfer, but was fine for hooking up things like keyboards and mice. USB 2 made things a little bit faster and now we started to be able to use things like little flash drives as storage devices. But USB 3 really pushed the speed limit up So now we can actually have fast transfer and use USB for storage. There are two flavors of USB 3, USB 3.1 Gen 1 and Gen 2. Gen 2 simply increased the speed. Now note that everything's backwards compatible. So if you have a port on your Mac that's USB 3.1 Gen 2, it can connect to any device that's Gen 1, USB 2, or original USB 1. Now Thunderbolt connections also have three different generations, and each one varies by speed. So Thunderbolt 1 was only 10 gigabits per second. That doubled for Thunderbolt 2 and doubled again for Thunderbolt 3. So when we put these two tables side by side, we can see how there's confusion. Because when you say you're connecting something using USB or Thunderbolt, what do you really mean? If you want to be really accurate, you should actually talk about both the port and the connection type. So for instance, you might say I'm using USB-A to connect a USB 3.1 device, or I'm using a Thunderbolt 2 port to connect a Thunderbolt 2 device. Including both eliminates any of the confusion. So if you have an older Mac, say about 5 years old, this is what you might have. You may have USB-A ports and also Thunderbolt 2 ports. Now what can you do with those? Well, the USB-A port can be used to connect to any USB 3.1 device and also backwards compatible with USB 2 or USB. The Thunderbolt port can be used to connect to any Thunderbolt 2 device, also backwards compatible to Thunderbolt 1. Now if you have a much older Mac, I should point out that instead of having a Thunderbolt 1 or 2 port, you may just have a mini DisplayPort port. Apple produced these for a couple of years, so you can't hook up any Thunderbolt devices at all. But you can hook up a screen using DisplayPort. The screen can either have a mini DisplayPort connector or a DisplayPort connector. One is just bigger than the other. But it doesn't matter as long as you have the right cable. So mini DisplayPort on your Mac to regular size DisplayPort on your screen is just a matter of having that particular cable. Now if we go with a modern Mac, we can see we've eliminated the USB-A ports and we've eliminated the old style Thunderbolt ports. Instead, we have just one type of port, a USB-C port. This can connect to USB 3.1 or backwards compatible with all of the previous versions of USB. It can also connect to Thunderbolt 3 and Thunderbolt 2 and Thunderbolt 1, and also I should point out mini DisplayPort. So a good way to think about this is think about the ports as people. And people would have a nationality. Say if somebody was from France. Now you would assume that somebody from France would speak French. But in fact they may actually speak more languages than that. So for instance this person is French but they speak both French and English. Now if you have another person and they only speak English, then if the two of them were to talk they would be talking in, of course, English. So let's turn these people into ports. Let's say the first person is a USB-C port and that's your computer. And the second person is a device that you're going to connect to it and that has a USB-A port. So since the first person is USB-C, they can speak both USB 3.1 and Thunderbolt 3. But the peripheral is just a USB peripheral. It just speaks USB 3.1. So when you connect the two with a cable, they're going to talk to each other using USB 3.1. But what if it's an older device, a USB 2 device? Well, fortunately, USB 3.1 is backwards compatible. So now the device that only speaks USB 2 can talk just fine to the computer because it's backwards compatible. Likewise, if the device is a Thunderbolt 3 device and you connect it to the very same computer, instead of speaking USB 3 to each other, they're going to speak Thunderbolt 3. And if the device is older and is USB 2, they would both talk USB 2. So let's look at some examples. Let's go back 10 years to a 15-inch MacBook Pro from 2010. Now this device has lots of different types of ports on it. It has some USB-A ports on it. It has an analog port for hooking up headphones. It has a dedicated power port that can only be used to plug power into the laptop. And it has a special port, a mini display port, that can be used to connect an external screen. That's all it can be used for. It looks like a Thunderbolt 1 or 2 port, but it's not. It can only be used to connect a screen and will speak mini display port to that screen. Now let's go forward 5 years. And we still have USB-A ports. And we still have analog audio. And we still have a dedicated power port. But now, instead of a mini display port, we've got a Thunderbolt 2 port. Which is great because not only can this port talk DisplayPort and be used to connect a screen, but can also talk to Thunderbolt 1 and 2 devices. So this port, even though it looks the same, is now much more useful. Now let's go forward to today. If you get a MacBook Pro today, you're not going to have any USB-A ports on it. You're not going to have a dedicated power port on it either. Instead, you'll have a bunch of USB-C ports. And these ports will be able to talk USB to any USB device, be able to talk Thunderbolt to any Thunderbolt device, and also DisplayPort to any DisplayPort device. Not only that, they'll be able to accept power into the laptop. So you can use any one of these ports to plug in your power adapter. So what you have now is a lot of versatility. One person may use the USB-C ports on their Mac one way, say connecting one to power, maybe another one to an SD card reader, maybe a camera is connected to a third one and a printer to a fourth one. Another person may decide to actually have power in one and two screens connected to two of the other ports. Now one of the problems with upgrading from a Mac that uses USB-A ports to one that uses USB-C ports is you may have a bunch of USB devices that use USB-A. Fortunately, you can easily adapt these to using USB-C. Apple sells a connector for $20 that has a short length of cable, but you can get for a few dollars little adapters that look like this that you can put onto the end of your USB-A cables to convert those ends to USB-C. You can usually get these in packs of two, three, or even more for pretty cheap. Another option is simply to replace the cable. Now if you have something like a flash drive, then the USB-A connector is built right into it, right? And there are also various devices where the wire is actually hardwired into the device, so you can't just swap out the cable. But if you have a device like a printer or scanner or something that has a cable that can be removed, you can simply replace the cable. Instead of USB-A to USB-B to connect a printer, just buy a new cable, USB-C to USB-B. And already some devices are shipping with both kinds of cables. For instance, I recently bought an external drive that actually had one cable that was USB-C and another cable that was USB-A. You just chose the one that worked for the computer you had. So I hope this video helps you understand the different types of connections you may come across when using Macs. If you have any questions, please ask them in the comments below. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.